I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of.
Never changes.
First off, the sound of that trailer is awesome.
Yeah.
I thought. Second of all, fall of 2008. Whoa, that's a long time to wait. Third of all, I've got to say, it's not the most impressive looking graphics engine that I've seen, but it does seem to have a level of detail that a lot of games are missing these days.
When you see that doll?
What, the
when you see how tiny that doll is? The doll
right.
At the very beginning, and it backs
right.
all the way up to show the whole...
Yeah, that's cool. That's absolutely cool, and I like that. But again, it's there's a lot of detail. Again, it's not the sharpest engine I've seen. It doesn't have all the glowy bloom lighting, but it sets a sort of a feeling, an emotion, you know, when you come out, especially the car, and the radio music fades away, and then suddenly it's just, you know, like, you know, the outside post-apocalyptic sound. So I'm looking forward to it. I love the first two Fallout games. I love post-apocalyptic settings, and you know, we've got a long time to wait for that, but we may be getting some more details.
What kind of game
that.
Is that, Wheat, just for me, because I haven't been paying attention?
It's
to
like
it.
A
like it, FPS
no it's
Resident
more
Evil.
Like it's more like action RPG, I would say. Now, this is a big change for the game, because the previous two Fallout games came a long time ago, so they were all like 2D, actually they were 3D models turned into 2D sprites, you know? If you remember like the Donkey Kong Country style, where they rendered all their animations in 3D, but then turned them into sprites, that's essentially what Fallout was, but it was an RPG, very open-ended, so you could kill who you wanted to, it would change the story, you know, you could save people.
You don't think this new one's going to be Oblivion?
God, dude, your Skype is fucking horrible.
That's what I'm guessing. During the next news story, I'm going to reconnect. I'll be back, guys.
All right. Oh, you haven't reconnected yet?
He's going to go back to his old rig.
Okay, perfect.
He's on a new rig right now.
Good, good. All right. Well, the first news story was supposed to be the Nyko Duo Charger for the Wii, but why don't you reconnect now, Force? Do it now. I'll get through a few news items here that are nothing too big. Nothing too big. You won't be missing anything. For example, Capcom recently registered a new patent. This new patent was Lost Planet Colonies in the United States on April 30th of this year. Now, it's unclear whether or not this is an expansion pack or an actual sequel to the game. However, you're probably not going to get an expansion pack for the 360 version. So my guess is that Lost Planet Colonies will probably end up being the next installment of Lost Planet. Now, is this make me happy? Yeah, I thought Lost Planet was okay. I'm a little bit upset that I haven't seen a sequel for Dead Rising, because I would prefer a sequel for Dead Rising over, say, you know, Lost Planet. I just thought that Dead Rising was so much better game than Lost Planet. But Lost Planet Colonies is coming, and who knows? Maybe it's some weird RTS, or maybe it's a whole completely game, and maybe it is an expansion pack. We don't know, but we do know that Capcom has officially registered for the patent of that. Here's another article, guys. English dubbing. I fucking hate it. I mean, I think it should die in a fucking fire. We should all be speaking Japanese, and the English language, especially when used in cartoons and video games, should suffer a holocaust.
But that it causes jobs, dog.
What do you mean?
There's people who like, whatever, just keep going.
There's people who like, what, our voice actors that really fucking suck and don't deserve to be getting work anyway?
Possibly.
That's a tough one, Wheat, because, I mean, while you enjoy reading subtitles, I fucking hate reading subtitles when I could just listen to the English track.
Fair enough. I just don't listening to an English track.
Like you, you think Shaolin Soccer's English dub is shit?
It is.
I can tell it's a dub. Of course, I know it's shit and it's not the original actors and the stuff that they say doesn't necessarily make sense in English. But hey, I like it like that because then I spend most of my visual time enjoying the cinematics of the movie and not reading subtitles.
Perfect,
the whole time.
Perfect. So I'm going to actually come back to you in just a second. Let me read through this and tell me if it applies to you in video games as well. Because now that I've gotten, of course, the holocaust of the English language off of my chest, Ubisoft's North American arm is working on Naruto Rise of the Ninja for the 360. Now, however, for once, they are actually going to be keeping the original voice actors from the Japanese anime.
That's pretty hot, actually.
That they won't be using the gay, I am Naruto Uzumaki.
That is pretty terrible,
dude. That's about how it is. Sasuke, let's join up with Sakura and fight the Akatsuki. I mean, it's just fucking bad, dude. It's really fucking terrible. So, basically, they're going to be keeping the original voice actors from the game. Now, in addition, the creator of the original series has actually gone through and pieced through the entire project and improved the whole thing. The reason why I bring this up is not because I'm going to tell you to rush out and buy Naruto Rise of the Ninja, although being the first 360 game and having the original Japanese actors, I might actually play this one. Also being done by Ubisoft, that looks good. What I want to see is more companies starting to do this. And why? Because I feel like, A, it lends better to the original source, and B, it takes less time to localize. It doesn't take as long to subtitle as it does to completely redub an entire soundtrack with English actors who typically suck ass. So is the same verdict on video games too? You know, Rance, I mean, I'm sure there's not many video games that you play.
I'm sure that I'm not going to be staring at subtitles the entire video game experience. And so Right. That's going to be cool because I do enjoy, especially in Naruto, I do enjoy listening to the Japanese guys' inflection and stuff when they play.
Right.
But my problem is that I'm staring at the bottom 2 inches of the screen the whole show and I don't get to see, you know, most of the shit that's going on because Right. There is quite a bit of depth
to
the dialogue.
Adapt.
Oh my God. Force, you sound like you're in the room. Okay?
And you know what? I switched to my new PC thinking I'd be able to do better.
The new PC sucks,
dude.
Force.
Your new PC blows.
Sorry, you can play Company Heroes, but I guess not.
Dude,
Skype.
Seriously, it's like you're sitting next to me versus last time you were on a fucking tin can and a piece of string.
Are you trying to use onboard with that other rig?
Yeah, I was using onboard. I had a better onboard though. I'm using onboard on this. I'm using NVIDIA.
Dude,
now.
There's no such thing as better on. There's no such thing.
My second question would have been to ask if you had a like a sound blaster in your current machine, but obviously you are using onboard there too. So maybe it's a configuration issue. I don't know.
So anyway, English dubbing. Good job to Ubisoft actually bringing over some Japanese soundtracks. So we've gone through the Lost Planet colonies. We talked about English dubbing. We see the Fallout 3 trailer. Force, why don't we go ahead and throw in the Nyko Dual Charger for the Wii review, and then we will get to our last news items, which ironically – actually, let me do one more. And then every – let me do two more. Two more?
All right.
Okay, two more.
First more. One is, hey. I didn't say anything.
Yes, you did. All right. First one is this. Finally, it's my turn, bitches. Finally, it's my turn to throw some exclusivities back in all your fucking faces. All right? Because you know I love to do that. It's like every time, Metal Gear Solid for the 360. Oh, boy. You know, what were the other 360 or PS3 titles that are getting ported over? Anyway, everyone thought that Final Fantasy was going to make it. Wrong. According to an executive of Square Enix quoted from IGN, they said this, noting that the...